Welcome to lecture number 8. See, one example on divergence and curl show that the vector field f is equal to x square minus yzi plus y square minus zxj plus z square minus xyk is irrotational. Find scalar potential phi such that f is equal to gradient of phi. So here again we want to show this f is irrotational as well as we find its scalar potential. So f is given as x square minus yz into I plus y square minus zx into j plus z square minus xy into k. Now del cross f, it is equal to I j k del by del x, del by del y, del by del z. Coefficient of f is x square minus yz, then y square minus zx and z square minus xy. So it is equal to I times del by del y of z square minus xy. So what is z? Derivative of z square with respect to y, it is 0, and derivative of minus xy with respect to y is, y derivative is 1, remaining is minus x. Minus derivative of del by del z of y square, 0, and del by del z of minus zx is minus x. Plus j times del by del z of x square is 0, minus derivative of z is 1, so minus y. Minus del by del x of z square minus x square, so z square derivative is 0, minus x derivative is minus 1 into y, so minus y. Plus k times del by del x of y square minus zx, so y square 0 minus z, and minus del by del y of y x square is 0 minus y derivative is 1 and z, so minus of z. So minus x plus x minus y plus y minus z plus z, so all become 0. So 0i plus 0j plus 0k, which is equal to 0. So we get del cross f, it is equal to 0, means f is irrotational. And if f is irrotational, we can write it as f is equal to gradient of phi. Now we want phi. So f1 is equal to y x square minus yz, then f2 is equal to y square minus zx, and f3 is equal to z square minus xy. Now what we want? We want now phi. So phi is given as integration of f1 dx plus integration of f2 dy plus integration of f3 dz. So this is, must be free from x, f2, and for f3 it must be free from x and y. Now what is integration of f1? Can I write whole term as it is x square minus yz dx plus integration of f2 dy. So f2, it must be free from x, so we don't want this minus zx term. We write only y square into dy. Plus f3 must be free from x and y, so xy term is separate, so we neglect that term and we write only z square term. So z square into dz plus constant of integration. So it is equal to integration of x square dx is x cube by 3 minus integration of dx is xyz plus integration of y is y cube by 3, y square is y cube by 3, and integration of z square is z cube by 3 plus c. So we got phi value, which is equal to x cube plus y cube plus z cube divided by 3 minus of x, y, z plus c. So this is our scalar potential phi. Now next example, prove that f is equal to 1 upon x square plus y square xi plus yj is solenoidal. Now what is solenoidal? Meaning of solenoidal means this will be the solenoidal vector if del dot f it is equal to 0. This we want to prove. So what we want to prove? To prove that del dot f is equal to 0. Now for del dot f we must know del as well as f. So f vector is given as x upon x square plus y square multiplied by I am writing it separately, and then second is y upon x square plus y square multiplied by j. Okay, what is f1 and f2 here? It is compare this with f1i plus f2j plus f3k. So f1 is equal to x upon x square plus y square, f2 is equal to y upon x square plus y square, and f3 we don't have here k coefficient, so it can be written as 0k. 0k means f3 must be equal to 0. Now what we want to prove? Del dot f. So we consider now LHS, which is del dot f. Del dot f, what is del? It is I times del by del x plus j times del by del y plus k times del by del z, and dot product of this vector with f vector. F vector is x upon x square plus y square into I plus y upon x square plus y square into j. Now dot product of two vectors, so it is equal to I dot I, j dot j, and k dot k. So it is del by del x of x upon x square plus y square plus del by del y of y upon x square plus y square, and third term is 0. So del by del z of 0, del by del z of 0. So we know that del dot f is del f1 by del x plus del f2 by del y plus del f3 by del z. Similarly, we write this all I coefficient of I with I, j with j, and k with k. Now we want derivative of this x upon x square plus y square. So you can use with respect to x, we want derivative. Ax is in numerator as well as in denominator. So we have to use quotient rule or u by v rule. So first, denominator, that is x square plus y square into derivative of numerator. Derivative of numerator is 1 minus numerator into derivative of denominator, which is 2x, divided by denominator whole square, that is x square plus y square is whole square, plus same for second term also, denominator, that is x square plus y square into derivative of numerator minus numerator into derivative of denominator, divided by denominator whole square, x square plus y square whole square. So this is equal to x square plus y square minus 2x square, and here this is first term, divided by x square plus y square whole square plus x square plus y square minus 2y square, divided by x square plus y square whole square. So it is equal to x square plus y square minus 2x square is y square minus x square, divided by x square plus y square whole square. And next term is y square, x square minus y square, divided by x square plus y square whole square. Now if we observe it carefully, denominator is same, so we can add numerator y square minus x square plus x square minus y square, divided by x square plus y square whole square. So minus x square plus x square, this get cancelled, remaining is 0. So we prove that here it is equal to del dot f, it is equal to 0. Del dot f is equal to 0 means f is solenoidal. F is solenoidal vector field. F is solenoidal. So thank you, my dear students.